Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your absolutely, extremely most favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right tonight. Been seeking the Lord here and talking to our Lord and our God. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. Blessed be the name of the Lord from on high. Hallelujah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into him, and they are saved. Praise his name. Hallelujah. I was going to play some worship music here, brothers and sisters, because, you know, I've said this before. The thing that I deal with most people, listen to me, this is probably most people, Christians I'm talking about, Christians. Now, of course, we know the lost. Of course, their problem is they need to get saved. They need to become born again. As Jesus said, no man can enter the kingdom of heaven except to be born again. John 3:3. Of course, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever shall believe in him, the Lord Jesus Christ, should not perish, but have everlasting life. And the Lord goes on to say, you know, that people that are not saved, the wrath of God remains on them or abides on them. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so those, you know, those people who are already born again, those of you, the biggest thing that people have, brothers and sisters, that, you know, my ministry, the ministry that God gave me, that I deal with, is people don't have an ear to hear or an eye to see what God is trying to show them and trying to tell them. So it's like this, brothers and sisters, as Jesus said it so simply, but yet it's so complicated for people, but it's very simple. As Jesus said, you must be like become like a little child in order to enter the kingdom of heaven. So you must seek and you shall find, the Lord said. Knock and it will be opened to you. Ask and you shall receive. So you have to seek, ask, and knock, brothers and sisters, and the door will be open to you. Jesus says in his word that, you know, all of God's answers to us in the New Testament, in the New Covenant, is yes and amen. Everything we ask God in Jesus' name. And Jesus said in John 15:16-17, there at the Last Supper, the Lord Jesus said, you know, heretofore you didn't ask anything in my name, but now you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he'll do it. Hallelujah, to bring glory to his name. Anything you ask the Father in my name, he's going to do it. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. As Jesus said in Mark 11:22-23-24, after he had cursed the fig tree and his disciples said, hey, you know, the tree's already dead. And Jesus said, oh, have faith in God, for whomsoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart those things that he saith. When he saith them, he shall have whatsoever he saith. You know, the Lord said saith many times in there. So you got to say it, brothers and sisters, by faith. You know, all these people get caught up in these different doctrinal titles and talk about, oh, they're the, you know, about word of faith. And really what the meaning of the of word of faith is that you speak it. Just like the text that is quoted from you. It's acting on the word of God and saying it. For the Bible says, Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So when I pray with people and I'll say to them, oh, you know, you believe that by the stripes of Jesus, you were healed, as it says in Isaiah 53, 2 Peter 2:24. Do you believe the word of God that says by the stripes of Jesus, we were healed? It says Jesus went about healing all that were sick. The woman with the issue of blood, she said within her heart, see, she spoke, if I can touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. She said it. She didn't just say it and do nothing. She did it and acted on it, and she believed, and she was healed. Jesus turned to her and said, daughter, be of good cheer. Thy faith has healed thee. When Jesus went back to Nazareth, to his own town, go look it up. Go Google the Bible. You know, nowadays with Google, you know, you can just look it right up, and you can find the Bible verses. When Jesus went back to Nazareth, he said they didn't believe him. They said, hey, isn't this the son of Mary and Joseph? You know, don't we know him? He's from here. You know, Jesus said, you know, a prophet is without honor in his own place among his own people. And then it says, go read the text. It says Jesus could do few miracles there because of their unbelief. Because of their unbelief. Just like that woman with the issue of blood, brothers and sisters, when she touched him of his garment, it says he felt the virtue go out of him. And then Peter said, listen to what Peter said. He said, Lord, because Jesus said, who touched me? And Peter's and the disciples are like, well, you know, lots of people are touching you, Lord. There's throngs of people. What do you mean, who touched you? That's what they said. Lots of people were touching him. It was like, who touched me? Well, you know, he's walking through a crowd and there's lots of people touching him, bumping into him. But one person touched him by faith. Virtue went out of him. Can you dig it, brothers and sisters? Can you have an ear to hear and receive the most simple, simple childlike information that the Lord has conveyed to us through His Word? It's so simple, but yet it always confounds the wise. The more educated, the more wealthy, the more relying on their own intelligence, people that you run into, the harder it is for them to bypass all of their, you know, natural and what they think is wisdom, earthly knowledge of man that they want to call wisdom. The harder it is for them to receive the simple, basic, childlike instructions that the Lord gives us. What does it say? Jesus said, you know, virtue went out of me. Somebody touched me and by faith, and virtue went out from me. So it, the potential and the power source, just like a light switch, brothers and sisters, in our house, the potential for electricity is always there. But until you go flip the switch, the lights aren't going to turn on. And what the woman with the issue of blood did, she flipped the switch of faith, and she said, just like Jesus commanded there, she did exactly what Jesus said in Mark chapter 11, verse 22, 23, and 24, what I quoted earlier. She said within herself, if I but touch the hem of His garment, I will be made whole. And she did it. She acted on it, and she was. She received it by faith. Jesus said, He said to her, be of good cheer, thy faith has healed thee. See, the Lord had already passed by. Lots of people were touching Him. Lots of things were going on. But everybody wasn't receiving miracles, but the woman who had the faith. Can you understand, brothers and sisters? All of these denominations, all of these doctrines, all of this on and on and on explanations, explaining away why people aren't being healed, explaining away why they don't have miracles in the church, having that form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. Hallelujah. For the Bible tells us that the Word of God, which Jesus is the Word, and then we have the written Word too. Jesus is the Word of God. The Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword. And it goes on to say, you know, dividing the, you know, the bone from the marrow, and even dividing the thoughts and intents of the heart. Hebrews 4:12. Quick and powerful, brothers and sisters. That's why you have to believe. If you believe, as Jesus told people, He said, let it be done unto you. These two blind people came to Him and said, you know, in Matthew, you know, Lord, can we receive our sight? And Jesus said, let it be done unto you even according as you believe, let it be done unto you. Can you understand that? When Paul was in Lystra, it says he preached the gospel in the book of Acts. I believe it's chapter 16. I could be wrong about that. Maybe 16 or 18. Yeah, 16 Paul, or 18. When Paul was preaching the gospel at Lystra, it says he preached the gospel there. And then there was a man who was crippled from his birth who was sitting there. And it said Paul perceived that the man had faith to be healed. Paul perceived he had faith to be healed. And Paul said unto him, in the name of Jesus Christ, arise and walk. And the man leaped and jumped. He was healed immediately. So Paul was giving the gospel. And through the gospel message, the man got the faith to be healed. So there's a part of the gospel message that you probably haven't heard at your dead religion church. As a matter of fact, let me say this. Your old mainline Protestants and Roman Catholicism and all that, they're not even giving the gospel, the complete gospel. And then when you get to your evangelical churches, non-spirit-filled evangelical churches, they're giving part of the gospel. Part of the gospel. You know, about being born again. But they don't give the full gospel. That's why they call it the full gospel churches. Churches that are giving the full gospel. That God is the God who is still the great I am. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He changeth not, the Bible says. God says, I changeth not. Hallelujah. There is no shadow of turning in Him. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. That's why Jesus spoke when the Sadducees said, you know, about the man with seven, the woman with seven husbands. She had her first husband died, and according to the law, since they had no children, according to the law, his brother is supposed to marry her, have children with her, and then those children will be counted unto his dead brother, that his brother might have an inheritance in Israel, so that the land and inheritance would stay, because only men could inherit. You know, it had to be to the children. And so the second brother had no children with it. He died. And the third brother, on to the seventh brother, they all died. And this woman was still childless. So when she gets to heaven in the resurrection, who will her husband be? And Jesus said, you know, to these Sadducees, see, they don't believe in the resurrection. That's why they're sad, you see. the Sadducees, they didn't believe in the resurrection. And then Jesus told them, you know, you've erred in the word, because when people in heaven, they get married or are neither given in marriage or taken in marriage because they're like the angels. So there's no marriages in heaven. But he said, did you not hear what God said to Moses from the burning bush? He said, I am the God of Abraham. I am the God of Isaac, and I am the God of Jacob. So see, he used that present tense word. See, because Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had already been dead for 500 years, or set, you know, between 500 and 300 years before Moses was there at the burning bush. So, but God didn't say, I was the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, meaning that they are there with God, and God is in outside of time. He is the great I am. That's why Jesus used that title for himself. He said, in John chapter 8, he said, before Abraham was, I am. Then he goes on, that's why they tried to stone him, because he was equal in him, saying he was equal with God. He said, I am the bread of life. I am the good shepherd. I am the light of the world. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the resurrection and the life. John chapter 11. I am the way, truth, and life. John chapter 14, verse 6. So the Lord made all, I am the good shepherd, John chapter 10. The Lord made all these declarations unto us, brothers and sisters, that he's with us right now in this moment. He changeth not. I, the Lord, changeth not. Hallelujah. He doesn't change. He still heals. He's still passing by. As I've mentioned before, brothers and sisters, there's an old gospel hymn, you know, Southern gospel hymn called He's Still Passing By. And he is still passing by like he did on the road to Jericho when the blind man was healed, brothers and sisters. I know I've talked about these things before if you've seen them. When he passed by the blind man on the road to Jericho, the man cried out and said, Jesus, thou son of David. You know, that's a title that the Israelites had come up with for the Messiah. They used that title. It means the Messiah. They said, like later on, they said, Hosanna to the Son of David on Palm Sunday. Here he is again. He says, Jesus, thou Son of David, have mercy. And it says all the people told him to be quiet. Leave him alone. Be quiet. But guess what that man did? Oh, brothers and sisters, that you might do that. That you might obtain the miracles of God. Like I've done with the ministry that the Lord gave me. What I've done by going to the Philippines. Doing the orphanages, all that. All by faith, no denominational structure, you know, making all this man-made rules and doing the orphanages and all that. Just by faith, acquiring it all by faith, the ministry, getting words for people, people being healed, saved, all that. All acquired by faith, brothers and sisters. That man on the road to Jericho, it says when they told him to be quiet, he cried more the louder and cried out more loud, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. Says Jesus turned unto him and said, what is it that you want me to do for you? He said, I might receive my sight. And the Lord said, you know, be it unto you according to your faith. Of course, he had great faith. Our brothers and sisters, that's the difference. You want to hear from God. You want to operate in the power of God. You want to operate in the kingdom of God. Not in some, is this old saying they always say, if you've been around church, you've heard this before. They say, you know, what did the Chinese pastor say when they brought him to America and he toured all over the states and went to churches? That what did he say? He said, the American church has done a lot and built lots of great buildings without God. It's amazing what the American church has got done without God. And that's the truth, brothers and sisters. 90% of these churches, people say, oh, you know, that's a great building, all that, God must be in it. No. If, you know, there's Mormons and God's not in that. They've got those big cathedrals. There's Jehovah's Witnesses. There's all these cults. And they've got all kinds of great buildings. And of course, God's not in that. Matter of fact, the devil's in all that stuff. All these cult leaders have all kinds of money and buildings because the devil is making sure that they're putting out the false gospel. But all these old mainline dead religious denominations who have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof, they're operating all in the flesh. And I want to say this to you. When you read about the churches in Revelation 2 and chapter 3, when you look at that last day's church that we're living in, church age, the Laodicean lukewarm church age, that text that people love to quote about salvation, where it's Jesus says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man opens to me, I will sup with him and he will sup with me. That text is written to the last day's church, not to individuals in that way. Of course, it is true for us individuals. Jesus is knocking at the door of the Laodicean church. And he says, if any man will open to me, I'll come in. So Jesus is outside the church. They've kicked him out. They put him out. They've rejected the one who is the root of the church, the source of all life and all living things. As Peter said on the day of Pentecost, you know, he who is the giver of life. And he said there in Acts 2 and 3 at the gate called Beautiful, you know, you've killed the author of life. In Acts chapter 3, Peter said it there when he healed, when they, him and John healed the blind man, or the lame man at the gate called Beautiful. He said, you've killed the author of life. Jesus is the author and finisher of all things, of creation. The Bible says all things were made by him, to him, and through him. And they rejected him. Isaiah 53, they rejected him, smitten. They struck him, pulled out his beard, gave him 40 lashes, save one. By his stripes we were healed. Jesus took those stripes for us. All things have been finished in Christ. The law and the prophets are summed up in Christ. They are finished and completed in Christ. Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. That is the good news, brothers and sisters. What I've given you in this video is the gospel. And one more piece that I haven't given you yet. It says the Lord Jesus Christ shall return to judge the quick and the dead. Now, and Paul said in Galatians, referring to those Judaizers as they come to mind, as I talked about all things are finished in Christ, and the Jesus Christ is the fulfillment of the law. The Apostle Paul tells us there in Galatians, he said, if we, he's talking about himself and the people, his entourage, he said, if we, or an angel from heaven gives you another gospel, let them be accursed or an anathema. And then he repeats it. Let me say again. If we or an angel from heaven give you a different gospel, let them be accursed. He said, let them be accursed. Our brothers and sisters, what I gave you is the gospel. You must call on the name of the Lord, as it says, Romans chapter 10, verse 9. If we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and God is raised from the dead, thou shalt be saved. If you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. Lots of times with the greasy gracers, they confess it with their mouth, but they're not really believing it in their heart. It's one side. The other side, people think they got to do all these works to earn their salvation, as it tells us in James. I'm not saved by my works. I'm saved unto do good works, brothers and sisters. And in Ephesians chapter 2, chapter 3, brothers and sisters, now you have just heard the word rightly divided. I am an ordained minister since 2001 on the YouTube to bring the truth and to rightly divide the word of God for you, brothers and sisters, that you may navigate all of the false prophets and pitfalls and entertaining nonsense of the YouTube community. Our brothers and sisters, when I started to make this video was to do something a little bit different. And what I started to do for this video was to come on here, and I'll say it right now, that we have to, let me just make a separate video, then I'll do that, brothers and sisters. I shall return, and I will make a second video that I'll load also.